dicots and monocots. So now we will talk about classification types. The first classification, there was three types of classification existed. Number one, artificial classification. Number two, natural. Number three, phylogenetic. Phylogenetic classification. So, but initially Aristotle classified organisms into plants and animals. So again, animals based on, if they have blood, anima, if they have blood, please do remember the organism, the animals which have blood, they are grouped as a anima. Which does not have blood, enema. Blood is not there. So this is Aristotle classification. This is a first. Aristotle is a father of biology, right? Yeah, so he is the pioneer in this all classification. So first, he only initiated a classification based on plants. They do not move. Animals, yes, they do move. So again, animals based on having blood, doesn't have blood. According to this, anima. So now we'll start about artificial classification. Artificial classification. What is the basis? Artificial classification basis. Basis is, see, different scientists worked separately, and they started their classification. In that, artificial classification is one, which is the first classification. So in according to the artificial classification, scientists have taken the basis is external morphological characters. External morphological characters based on externally visible characters. Some scientists they are, number one, in this artificial classification, Aristotle is there. Number two, Linnaeus. Number three, Caspar Bauhin. Number four, Theophrastus. Pliny Elder. These Pliny Elder. All these scientists have given their contribution towards artificial classification based on external morphological character. External morphology, we have spoken last entire chapter, morphology, based on morphology. plant will have separate characters. You know, roots, stem, leaf, inflorescence, fruit, seed, all are morphological characters. So basis, external morphological, scientists are there. And here, a drawback, but it is not broadly accepted by all scientists. So they do have some drawbacks. Main drawback is they didn't take the phylogeny. Phylogeny means evolutionary relationship. So phylogenetic relationship is absent. Phylogenetic relationship is not taken, is not considered or not taken. Number one drawback. Number two, most importantly, vegetative and reproductive characters are equally considered. So remember, in this classification, the question will be asked like this. Who proposed artificial classification? Which scientist's contribution is there? This is one type of question. Scientists are Aristotle, Linnaeus, Bohm, Theophrastus, and Pliny Elder. Remember, Aristotle, we have spoken here, first initiated classification entire organisms into plants and animals. So now, as we are talking about plant kingdom classification, all these will come: artificial, natural, phylogenetic. So according to Aristotle, plants are classified into three types: herbs, shrubs, and trees. So this is the first important area about plant classification, that is artificial classification. So remember, herbs means very short. Herbs means, you know, generally we use medicinal purpose all herbs. So very short height, okay? Shrubs means they are taller than herbs. Shrubs means taller than herbs and shorter than trees. Trees means they are very long, very tall. So mostly angiosperms all are trees, mostly. So this is the first artificial classification. If you are understood, then we'll go for natural classification there also. What is the basis?
Answer.
Who are the scientists behind it? Once you completed. Neha? Only one direct question. These two only they will give. Basis and scientists. Shall I erase it? All right. So now, second, please keep heading natural classification. Natural. natural classification. Right, regarding natural classification, second one, basis, on which basis they have classified means, basis is not only morphology here, not only external morphology, but also anatomy also they have considered. We have discussed about anatomy of plants. Yes? So,
yes, sir.
Yeah, so here is important point. On which basis natural classification is started? If the question comes like this, basis is number one, morphology of plants, and second, anatomy of plants. All right. Number three, not only morphology, anatomy, even the ultrastructure of plants and cytology, embryology, all are considered in natural classification. So scientists' contribution towards this natural classification is John Ray is one scientist, and D. Condole, and D. Jesu. Most importantly, one more scientist whose contribution is a lot, Bentham and Hooker. So all these scientists contributed a lot about natural classification on basis of this. So here we will talk about his classification, Bentham and Hooker. But what are the drawbacks? As I told you, drawback, it is just like artificial classification. Number one is, they did not consider phylogenetic relationship is absent. Relationship is absent, they did not consider. We will talk once Bentham-Hooker classification, once we discuss, drawbacks will come one by one. Till here, if you finish, I'll tell now. What is Bentham-Hooker classification? Bentham-Hooker. Yeah. See, here very important Bentham-Hooker classification. According to Bentham-Hooker, plants are classified here initially classified cryptogams, phanerogams. Cryptogams and phanerogams. So now phanerogams are classified. I have explained. Cryptogams means Do they give flower?
No flowers or seeds.
No flower and no seed. Phanerogams means they are flowering plants. That's why cryptogams are also called non-flowering plants. Phanerogams are called flowering plants. So here, again, phanerogams, according to Bentham and Hooker classification, according to Bentham Hooker classification, he classified phanerogams into here dicotyledons, gymnosperms. Here he has given gymnosperms and monocotyledons. 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 So this is Bentham Hooker classification. After that, again dicotyledons classified into again three polypetale means you know. Petals are free. Gamopetale and it is perianth. You know, here both there is no sepal and petal. So there is no differentiation or distinction between sepal and petal. That is a perianth. So here again this gamopetale is classified into infire heteromere and bicarpellate. See, inferi means inferior ovary. Heteromere and bicarpellate means superior ovary. So this is an important classification which has given by Bentham and Hooker scientists. So here Bentham and Hooker has given classification based on this morphology, anatomy, ultrastructure, cytology and embryology. But here this classification also not broadly accepted because phylogenetic relationship is not considered. Phylogenetic means, please do write somewhere, phylogenetic means evolutionary relationship is called phylogenetic. Phylogeny means evolutionary, the study of evolutionary relationship between organisms. So simply you can write study of evolutionary relationship. Study of evolutionary relationship among organisms is called phylogeny. So that is lacked here. That is not considered either in artificial select classification or natural classification. They could not consider phylogenetic relationship. And another drawback is here, come to drawback. Second drawback is gymnosperms should be kept before here, before dicotyledon. But gymnosperms are not developed than angiosperms, so gymnosperms should be placed before dicotyledon. So this is one drawback. Gymnosperms position is not acceptable. Position is not correct. Not correct because dicotyledon and monocots, dicots and monocots are part of angiosperms. So before angiosperms only gymnosperms should be there. But according to Bentham-Hooker classification, gymnosperms are placed between dicots and monocots. So this is one drawback. And the third drawback also there. Orchidaceae family is very advanced family, but it was given a primitive position.